Hey everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you how to create a macOS X Sierra boot disk. Now there's two ways that Apple recommends on how to do it. One way is through the terminal, which actually works more times than the other one, but the other way is using this application called DiskMaker X6, and actually it's free, so you don't have to pay anything for it. But the trick is that sometimes DiskMaker fails in Sierra, and if it does on particular thumb drives, then it's good to know the other method as well. So I'll show you both methods on this video. To get started, you're going to need to download the OS X installer again. So you would have to go into the App Store, look up your macOS Sierra. In this case, I already have it downloaded, so it says install here. It should say download. You should look for it in your purchase tab, and you're going to download it. Now, once you download it, it's going to pop up to ask you if you want to install it again. You know, when you get the first time the installer starts, it looks something like this. When you get up to this window, don't hit continue. Just go to the install menu and quit it, because you just want the application. As soon as it installs it, it deletes it. And also, you're not looking to reinstall the app right now. So you would just hit quit. And now it's sitting actually in your applications folder. So now you're ready to use the disk maker. So this is the first method. So you've downloaded your install. You now have to put in your thumb drive. Now I'm actually using this thumb drive, which is a little bit of a funny looking thumb drive. It's a Snorlax one. The reason is, in all the situations in the past when I've created a USB boot disk, whenever I need it, I'm never sure which of my thumb drives it is. So this time I'm going to use a Snorlax and have it set up on my computer desk, keep me company, and when I do need it, I can grab it right off the desk and I'll know it's this one. I'll leave a link for it. I got it on Amazon. It's not expensive. It's a 16 gig, and you can make these thumb drives from 8 gigs and up. So you can, even if you have them laying around the house, you could use that one. I'm just using the Snorlax one for fun. Okay, so once you've downloaded the OS X and you have your thumb drive plugged in to your computer, you're now going to want to go into Disk Utility, because you're always going to want to initialize it and make sure it's initialized properly. If you go into the Go menu, you go into Utilities, and you look up Disk Utility, you'll see it here. Here it is. Okay, you just double click on it and it will open. And at this point, look for the disk that you have. At this point, these are disk images over here. This is the external drive, so it would be this one. And in this case, you're going to click not the main area, but here. And you're going to go to erase. And you're going to want to pick macOS Extended Journaled. Okay, so that's the one that you want to pick. You're going to click erase. It's going to go through the process. If it erases successfully, then you have a drive that you can use. All right. And that's all it takes to get the drive set up. So now you have the drive set up and it's mounted here, as you can see. And now we're going to go to do the first method, which is with the disk maker. You go to this website. I'm not going to go through the details of downloading it, but you just click on that. You download it. It'll show up in your downloads folder. Once it's in your downloads folder, double-click on the DMG image and just drag it into your applications folder. Once you have it in your applications folder, you'll see an icon that says DiskMaker X6. You simply double-click on it. And when it opens up, it's going to ask you, do you want to do Yosemite, El Capitan, or macOSSierra? So it actually can do all three. But you do need to have the installer in order to do it. We downloaded the OS X installer for Sierra, so that's the one that we're going to use for this. So I'm going to click on that, and it's going to automatically know that I have a copy of it in my applications folder. And it says, do you want to use this copy? I'd click use this copy, and it's going to ask for my password, and then it's just going to do it. And when it's done, you're going to have a little disk sitting on it right here on your desktop. And it does take about 20 minutes to do, sometimes a half an hour. So I would leave it alone for half an hour, come back and check, and see if you can boot off of it. If you can't, then it didn't work properly, and you might want to use the next method I'm going to show you. So let's take a look at that. The second method is already built in from Apple, so you don't need to download any applications. You do need the installer, which you've already done, and you do need to initialize your disk. However, you're going to change the name of the disk to, instead of install macOS Sierra or whatever you named it, you're going to name the disk this. The only reason is because in the terminal command, it refers to this. So you could change it, but then you'd have to change the terminal command that I'm going to provide for you. So I would just name it just like that. And all I did was click on the name and change the name of the disk. Okay, at that point, you would then want to run this command. And of course, I will leave this command inside comments area so you can copy and paste it. But just keep in mind, if you did not name the thumb drive that you have after you initialize it to this particular name, the terminal command won't work because it's referring to it right here. So that's why you have to do it. So next, we're going to go into the terminal. And again, you go to utilities. And in this time, instead of going to the disk utility, you're going to look for something called terminal. There it is. Okay. And you double click on it and you open it. And at that point, you're simply going to paste the command and hit return. It's going to ask you for a password. That's the password for your admin account on the computer or for the account that you're logged into. You put it in and it's going to run. Now, it takes about a half an hour to run, but I did a screenshot of what it would look like as it's going through the process. And here it is. So as you can see, after I put the password in, it starts erasing the disk 10, 20, 30, 100%. So obviously you don't want anything on that disk that you can't erase, because once it's erased, it's gone. Then it's copying the installster file, automatically knows that it's sitting in your applications folder, so it's automatically copying it. Tells you copy's complete. Now it's making the disk bootable. Then it's copying boot files. Copy complete, done. Once you get to the done, you're done, and that's it. That's all it takes. Really, really simple to make these boot disks. Not that challenging. Either way will work. The first way with the disk maker X is a little bit easier, but the terminal command is just as easy, and it actually fails less of the times with Sierra. I'm not quite sure why. I think it has something to do with the thumb drives. Some of the thumb drives work better using the terminal command. So if you've got an old thumb drive laying around or one of the newer ones, this particular Snorlax one that I bought worked better with the terminal. So either way, one is free. So I hope you enjoyed it. Like the video if you liked how to make a boot disk. And please subscribe to my channel. And thanks for listening.